Once the log is faceted, the log can be carefully studied to establish the best location for the gunwale. The first consideration is to make certain no knots will be at the location of the gunwale. Knots are weak spots in the structure, and a knot on the gunwale might cause a serious break during the spreading process. It is also a good idea to look for heart checks and to try to keep them from occurring on the sides of the canoe. Checks are also a potential source of splitting during the spreading process. Ideally, heart checks and knots are best positioned in the top area of the log above the gunwale line, as that area is removed in the carving process. With the log in the upright position, you can use a straight, flexible stick or spline to mark the gunwale line. This will take a few crew members to help position and mark the curved line. With the drawing and model as a guide, the pre-spread gunwale can be established, taking into account the resultant shape of the canoe after spreading.
This is going to be where the finished gunwale will be after we spread the canoe. It'll be eight inches out from there and 22 inches from the base. So I'm going to take this stick and pull it out to here. That's where the gunwale is going to be.
Crew members are stationed at each end of the faceted log, holding the spline, but allowing it to be pulled outwards at the middle to the desired post-spread width and height position. Once that post-spread shape is established, the spline is held firmly at the ends of the canoe and the spline is lifted up and onto the faceted log. Wherever the spline touches the surface, a pencil line is scribed along its length. The resulting line is somewhat strange looking, as the center area is higher than the ends, but will be lowered as the middle spreads out and down later on. Repeat the process for the other side of the faceted log. Next, crosscuts are made down to the scribed gunwale line, and axes are used to remove the material between saw cuts. If possible, the center portion of the log can be saved for later repairs or other projects, as it may be a fair amount of material. For more control in removing material down to the scribe lines, ship adds are used. It is important to make the gunwale line surface fairly flat across the width of the canoe, as measuring templates will be used as a surface as a base.
Okay, because this end of the canoe log was 3 inches smaller than the other end, and I wanted it to be the same at each end. I wanted to flatten off a place and then add another piece. And in order to do that, we want this to be perfectly flat. And so I'll rough it off first, and we use a nice straight edge that's been blackened with a pencil. And when you rub it across, it'll leave a dark mark. That means you got a high spot. And to take care of that, take this little hand plane and just true it up. Sometimes it takes a lot of fooling around to get it perfect. When we don't want any air spaces in there when we glue this piece onto this piece. Now we're using Gorilla Glue, which is a wonderful glue, very strong. As long as both surfaces come into tight contact, and you either clamp it down or bolt it down. Okay, this surface has been finished all the way down, top of the gunwale line, all the way across both sides of the gunwale. Now I'm going to make a plumb cut right here and right here, and the same thing on the other end. Clear down to the bottom. We're going to remove all that material. And then it'll be ready to flip over.